Website speed plays a huge role in user experience, SEO, and sales. It's gonna be more important than ever to know exactly what you need to do on your Shopify store. So I wanna begin by saying that Shopify recently, as of this year, they changed the way that we look at speed on the store. So before, we and Google and Shopify, they used to care about this number right here, which is sort of like an overall number that keeps track of your performance, right? This is still available. This is still available for people. You can go to Page Speed Insights on Google and put in your URL, and it will show you this number. This number really doesn't matter that much. Doesn't move the needle that much. Google has come out to say there's three new metrics that we're going to track, and those three metrics are the ones that Shopify has also adopted here at the very top. So we have loading speed, interactivity, and visual stability. Now, these three metrics correspond to the three things that Google is basically saying. These are gonna be the core web vitals. As you can see, we have LCP, which is largest contentful paint. We have CLS, which is cumulative layout shift. And we have INP, which is interaction to next paint. All these things probably mean nothing to you, but I'm gonna show you exactly what this means and how you can potentially make fixes on your store to help with these. The best thing that they've done is get rid of that number, because that number is so arbitrary. A 50 here really doesn't tell us too much, right? There's a lot of room to think that, oh, we need to be in the 60 or the 70 or the 80, or like, I mean, there's stores that they try to go to 100 and it's just impossible. So what they have done really well, I believe, is they've given you these three metrics: the good, moderate, and poor. So instead of trying to give you some kind of number to strive for and to be 100%, they're just telling you like, look, as long as you're in the blue, as long as you're in the good, then you're good to go. Like, there's nothing necessarily that you need to do here. Now, if you're in the moderate or the poor, that's where you really need to see what's available for you and what things you can change on your store. But these three metrics, and then the scoring system for each of these, is gonna be what you definitely need to pay attention to when it comes to speed on your store. So this first one is going to be the loading speed. So if we click on each one of these, they'll give you a little bit more data. With the loading speed, what we talked about is the LCP, which is the largest contentful paint. And really all this means with the LCP, the largest contentful paint, it's gonna be the biggest image on your store. So if we go to our Bit Branding website, the largest image here is going to be this hero image. And for a lot of you, it's probably going to be some kind of big hero image like this. Obviously, depending on your store, you may have maybe a image with text, you know, section here. You may also have a slider that goes through different images. So these are all things that play into largest contentful paint. So all they're really trying to help customers with, right, is the biggest media that you have on your page, how quickly is that actually loading? Because it's gonna be sort of, you know, either the biggest message or the most important thing in terms of visual hierarchy, typically. Now, we're talking about exclusively here on the homepage, but the largest, you know, contentful paint, it could be a piece of text, it could be a video, it could be a GIF, depending on the page that you're on your site. So for example, on a product page, the largest image is going to be the product image by itself, right? That's gonna be the largest piece of media that we have in here. And again, for something like an about page, it may be, you know, this text, or it could be this actual video that plays here on the left-hand side. So now that you understand what Shopify is looking at and Google, what they're looking at when it comes to this, now it's when you have the opportunity to potentially make some changes to this. In terms of some of the biggest things that you can control, right? Because there's gonna be certain aspects that you can't, or they're outside of your control, right? The biggest things that you can control, one is gonna be lazy loading. So when it comes to lazy loading is the website essentially taking a little bit of time off, right, from loading things up until you actually scroll to that point. So the hero section, or that big hero image, shouldn't be lazy loaded, which means that you want that big hero, or the largest piece of content on that particular page, you want it to load first and quickly. All the other elements on that page, sure, you can enable them to lazy load. Now, if you're thinking about how do I do that on my theme, from my experience and what I've seen, is it depends really on the theme if they give you the option to lazy load. Hopefully in the future, this will be something that's enabled for everybody. But let's just take a quick look to see this particular theme that we have installed here, to see if it gives us the option to lazy load content. A lot of times you're gonna see see this under the theme settings, and it may have like advanced, or it may show maybe some like animation. So we have, look, so we have page transition, loading bar. Let's go in the other placement. I didn't really see it there, but the other placement would be right within the actual section. Sometimes if you scroll down here, you may see an option. And again, it's gonna be very explicit. It's gonna say, do you want to lazy load this content right here? Yes or no. And that's where some themes have it as a universal rule, which you will find under theme settings. It looks like this one doesn't necessarily have it. Other themes are also gonna give you a little bit more granular control. So you'll have to go on each of the sections and either enable the lazy load or turn off the lazy load. Okay, so here I have a trial version of Impulse, just to kind of give you an example of how that would actually look. If we click here on our hero slideshow, you'll see that right there. So lazy load images. So lazy loading should be enabled when section images are below the fold, right? So it shouldn't be that very first hero image. So for this particular example, we want to not check mark that we want to lazy load these images here. That's gonna be better for SEO. It's gonna be better for speed optimization on your store. Now, besides lazy loading, what else can you control? I think the second thing that you can control is going to be whether you do this right here, a slideshow or a static image. Our recommendation is always doing a static image. A static image provides the customer just a singular thing to look at and not multiple things, right, moving around in your store. Beyond that, right, it's also going to help with loading speed, because the website now doesn't have to load 2, 3, 4, 5 huge images. It just has to load that singular hero image. So even if your theme has the option to do a slideshow like this, again, I would try to tell you to not do a slideshow. And even this one actually, in parentheses, has optional slideshow, because some people think like, oh, that's a slideshow, I can't do anything. A lot of times with these slideshows, you can technically remove that additional slide and keep it into a singular slide. But if the theme does have the option for a single image with text, is usually what it's called, I would definitely do that, because you have all these additional bells and whistles for like the arrows and the sliding and parallax that happens with slideshows that the theme doesn't necessarily have to load, right, if you use a section like image with text. The third thing that you can do to help with this particular metric is going to be potentially not using a big hero image, right, and as part of your hero section, using an image alongside with text. So if we click on, let's just see here on this example, image with text. Okay, yeah, they do have the option. I think by default, they do like these two images in here, but this can work as a hero image, right? And by default, you are essentially having potentially two or just one, you know, smaller image on your hero section overall. Your hero section doesn't mean that you need to have a huge image part of, like, a hero is just, it's called hero because it's that first section that shows up. So having a smaller image, if this is something that you're struggling with on your store right now, having a smaller image using a section like this would be very, very beneficial. And also just a quick note on this too, which I've seen this happen once or twice, where it thinks that the Klaviyo pop-up is the biggest piece of content. So with that, my suggestion would be to make sure that your Klaviyo image is actually being compressed, because Shopify now, they do a pretty good job of compressing your images. And I think they do a fairly decent job. So their best practice right now is send us your highest quality image and we'll take care of compressing that. To be honest, like, again, they do a pretty good job with that, and I haven't had any problems whatsoever on my stores so far since they've added this new feature. But if you still think that you need to compress them further, then you can look at something like TinyIMG or go to bulkresizephotos.com and compress your images even further. But again, I don't think that's necessary. But when it comes to additional apps, something like Klaviyo, right? The images on that Klaviyo pop-up are not gonna be compressed by Shopify, because it's sort of an external image coming in from Klaviyo. So my suggestion there would be to compress that image. And I mentioned it, but I wanna show you. So bulkresizephotos.com. This is really nice. You can choose your image. Let's just pick this right here. And we can actually select either file size, dimensions. Usually with file sizes, right, we wanna make sure that we're under that 250 kilobytes for your images, especially if Klaviyo doesn't take care of any compressing, then doing the around, you know, 250, 300 kilobytes for the image. And then when it comes to the actual format, if your image doesn't have any transparent background, then just do a JPEG. JPEG is gonna be the best format for photography or for any sort of graphic. Now, if you have some kind of transparent background, then I would probably recommend using the PNG. Okay, so those are some things that you can control and you can do. The other great visual that they give you here is the fact that you can, in a timeline, right, see how your customers are actually, how they're experiencing your website. So this is what we see here from October 5th to November 2nd. We see like there was actually a period of time here, October 13th, for whatever reason, our largest Contentful paint was 5 seconds. So there were some changes. So you can see here from October 5th to the 7th, we made 20 different changes to the theme. And then we installed a new app, the Gem Pages Builder. So this is actually really, really cool because it's teaching you on the fact that when you make these changes, sort of these are the results, right? Or some of the experience that your customers are having. Versus like before, when we used to do the page speed insights, like this is just like a robot crawling through your website in this particular time and moment that you click, you know, run the report. Versus this is actually showing you a timetable of all your pages on your site with all your customers that are coming in. So it's actually giving you real data from your customers. So again, this right here just gives you just really good data on the changes that you've made and how it's actually affecting. You can also change the timeline. You can go by device to try to determine and pinpoint, like, is this happening on mobile or desktop, etc. So definitely good info in here. Now, if we go back to our core web vitals, the next one's gonna be interactivity. So with interactivity, this is gonna be how quickly are things moving on your site once you actually click on something. So let me see if I can show you an example. So this will be the interaction to next paint. And yeah, right here, we can see this example. So on the left hand, the customer is clicking almost once or twice for them to see that dropdown come through, versus on the good responsiveness, they click once and something pops up automatically. To be honest, when it comes to interactivity within your store, the theme may have some options. And I think we saw it earlier on our R's where we're using concept in here. We have an option to disable animations. So disabling animations could help with interactivity. Right now, we don't have any problems. Like, we're in the good, we're in the blue. So I don't feel the need to take this off or turn this off right now. Now, something that you may not be able to control is gonna be some of these additional third-party apps that you install in your store. And that's why we always recommend audit your apps. Make sure that if you have apps that you're not currently using, or if there's a better alternative, right, for this particular app, then make sure that you switch them out. And again, the best way to look into that would be right here. Looks like we got a huge spike right here, and it looks like we added tiny icons. So it looks like tiny icons for us may not be the best, because the interactivity, right, how long things are taking whenever someone clicks on it, this is not gonna give you specifics, right, on that, you know, the fact that it is that particular app, but it gives you a very good idea. I mean, literally right after we added that app, that number spiked, right, in terms of, and we're talking about milliseconds here. So it's not a huge deal. And that's why right now, again, we're still in the blue with interactivity. So not super concerned about that, but definitely something worth looking into. Maybe tiny icons may not be the best app to use. There may be some alternatives, or potentially maybe some custom coding in order to keep this at a more blue level line. Now, the last metric here is gonna be visual stability. Visual stability, or the cumulative layout shift, is gonna be important. This is where, and I've seen it sometimes and I don't have a good example, but if an element loads on your site and then it gets sort of pushed down for this other thing to load on top of it. And again, a lot of times this has to do with actual apps that are installed that sometimes take a little bit longer to load, right? And that's where the lazy loading comes in. That's actually great. And the next thing is going to be all A/B testing different apps, right? Just to make sure that visual stability is in the blue. So again, right now we don't have a whole lot in here to change with visual stability. Let me see if I can show you an example, because Google has an example of that here. So cumulative layout shift, or the CLS. They have a little animation here that they've submitted an order, right? But they didn't mean to, but once they clicked on it, something moved. And that's why they considered this metric to be very important, is because it can be very, very frustrating for customers if they wanted to push on the no go back, but they accidentally end up clicking on complete the purchase. And that's because there was one thing that was about to load and then didn't load fully up until the exact same time. So this is a very, you know, particular, you know, case scenario here, but this stuff does happen and it's very, very frustrating. And basically what Google is saying, like, if your store is doing these things, we're gonna penalize you. We're not gonna show you when someone, you know, Google searches for your particular brand, like, we may not show you this particular page because we know that there are problems in here. So this is something that is gonna be very important. And again, it's one of those metrics that you you don't have a whole lot of control over, except for A/B testing different apps and actually reviewing the data as it comes in here. The other recommendation that I would probably have you do is install something like Microsoft Clarity. And with Clarity, you may be able to pinpoint exactly when something like this is happening. So, and if you see a huge spike here, for example, on October 25th, you can go back to your Microsoft Clarity data, go to October 25th, and watch some of the videos that are people, you know, going through your store. With Microsoft Clarity, this is the same thing as like something like Hotjar, where it just allows you to not showcase, but allow you to record the user's sessions. So if you look here, like session recordings, it will give you a list of all the sessions that are coming in. You can click play and it's literally a video of someone going through your store. Things like this, it will affect the speed of your site just a little bit, but I mean, you can see we have Microsoft Clarity installed in our website here on Shopify, and like we have all three metrics as good. So it's not really impacting speed on our store so far. It's been okay, but and it's gonna, the data that it gives you is gonna be very, very beneficial because you can compare it with maybe some spikes that you see here in the data for your core web vitals. So now they have a better understanding of all three of these core web vitals. There's also just a few best practices that they give you here from the get-go. That's going to be uninstalling any unused apps. With this, it comes a little caveat where sometimes certain apps, once you uninstall them, they may leave some additional code behind. To be honest, that's going to be very hard to kind of pinpoint and track and see exactly where that particular code is. A lot of times it's really under that theme.liquid file. So if we go here on the online store and we go to edit code, we go to our theme.liquid, we'll see some things. For example, let's scroll down here. Looks like this right here is our Microsoft Clarity code. So if we decide to uninstall something like Microsoft Clarity, that one is actually one that we have to do manually. So we have to go in here, find this particular piece of code and get rid of it. A lot of times it's really, you could do that control F and then try to find something. So like, for example, like Klaviyo, maybe in here, I don't think it is, but Klaviyo, there may be some other apps that basically you'll see here, it says render. So you have to kind of go in here and delete it. This is something that is not super easy to do. There may be an app that you could potentially search for all of your files. Like I said, theme.liquid will probably be your main file that you'll have some of these elements. But beyond that, you will have to potentially go in on a, you know, page by page basis to make sure that those things are removed. So at a glance here, you could even see, for example, these are all gem pages or created by gem pages. If we delete gem pages, some of this code may linger here in the back end, and it's not good, right? It's not good. So I don't have a universal, you know, clean this up and get it done, because it's gonna differ on a case by case basis depending on the theme that you're using as well, and depending on the app that you're actually removing from your store. A couple of the other things that they recommend here, tracking pixels. So limit the use of tracking pixels. Us as marketers, like, we want to have all the tracking and all the data. So that one's a little bit harder, but definitely have tracking pixels that you're actually actively using, right? Don't install the Pinterest tracking pixel just because like one day you may run ads on Pinterest. Just make sure that the ones that you are using, you are actually taking advantage of. Next up is serve best images on every device. Again, this is something somewhat new that Shopify is taking care of compressing images. So they're basically telling us, like, give us your best image and we'll take care of the rest. But if you want to compress even further, you can technically. And that's where bulk resize photos or Tiny IMG, which is an app, can come in handy. And then lastly, keep your themes updated. I'm saying that as my theme right now is currently out of date. But you, if you have purchased a theme through the Shopify store, which we highly recommend, you will see these messages where right now we're on current 1.4.1 version and they are on concept version 2.1.0. So upgrading the version of your theme is also gonna keep things up to date. Obviously, theme developers are gonna keep using best practices, and if something changes in the future, they're gonna implement those changes, right? So you wanna be able to take advantage of all those things. If you purchase the theme through the theme store, you will get all these updates automatically to your store. If you're interested in knowing how to upgrade your theme version and how that process actually works, you can check out this video here next.